Alright, back at camp. Wet morning, so I'm just going to let the tent dry out a little bit and have a little bit of a bigger breakfast and I think pack up and just head up to this next bench and see what I can get into up there. Just want to do a little bit on the gear that I'm using. Single wall tent from Mountain Hardware, the Waypoint. Came in at 2.5 pounds, which is pretty light, big enough for me to sit up in. It's a single wall tent, so you get the lightness, but you also get the condensation. So what my wife and I have found that looks pretty slick is one of these pack towels. And in the morning, it's so wet inside of the tent that I'll actually wipe the inside of the tent down, and that helps keep from that moisture falling onto my sleeping bag and myself. And I'm not soaked by the time I get out of my tent. That's the tent bit. I'm sleeping on a XPED ThinMat 7 with a built-in pump. It's like 3 inches thick, and I really get a solid night's sleep on this thing. I have a patch kit in case I get a hole in it. It might be a little bit heavier than just your foam type of mat, but I think the comfort is well worth the extra ounces. So I think it's coming in about 1 pound. Sleeping bag, Marmot Couloir in a Zero. Might be a little overkill, but again, I like to be warm and comfortable. Hopefully that'll keep me out here a little bit longer. As far as the clothes that I'm wearing, mostly Sitka gear. This is their base layer shirt. I've actually only been wearing this during the day when it gets warm. Keep on its own. And then in the mornings and the evenings, I'm going with a 260 weight from Icebreaker as my base layer. And then the Sitka fleece top. Smart wool boxer shorts. Sitka set pants on the bottom. I've got a pair of smart wool 3/4 length bottoms in there in case it gets really cold. And of course, 4 pairs of smart wool socks are the only way to go. This is day 3 and I'm still on my first pair, so that's good. Rain jacket, Arc'teryx, Alpha SL. Super light, small. I think it's coming in underneath a pound for men's large. Pack, Osprey, Crescent 75. Not a hunting pack, but a great back internal frame backpacking pack. I've packed a lot of elk out in this pack. It rides well. It's not the most quietest material, but again, comfort and. Can't afford one of those mystery ranch packs yet, so for now this is going to do. Total pack weight, I came in at about 51, 52 pounds. That was with 12 pounds of food, about 2 pounds of food a day, and counting 100 ounces of water, which is probably about 6 pounds of water. The only thing that really wasn't in there was the Binoc. A few calls, the camera, everything that I carry in my pants, basically in the cargo pocket, the GPS and the rangefinder. But that included everything else, so 50 pounds for 6-7 days, not too bad, I don't think. Definitely a lot of work chasing elk around with that thing on your back, so for last night's hunt and this morning's hunt, I packed with me, again, extra weight, but this little fanny pack, and it allowed me to, you know, bring my knife and some snacks, my flagging, my emergency supplies, first aid kit, and my poop kit. And I really hope that everybody has a good one and practices good backcountry ethics when they're out there doing this. I could probably get a lighter shovel, but this is what I have right now. That way we can get 6 to 8 inches deep. like to pack the baby wipes, keep you fresh. Can also use them for the, you know, face and the hot spots. But, yeah, hopefully everybody's using a shovel. It's awfully hard to really kick a hole that's 6 to 8 inches deep. That's all the gear I brought with me.